Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the most common Chrysler 5.2 Magnum engine problems. The Chrysler 5.2 Magnum V8 engine is a part of the Chrysler LA engine family, and it was initially introduced in 1992 and remained in production through 2003. The 5.2 Magnum offers 230 horsepower and 295 foot-pounds of torque, so nothing crazy for power output from a large 5.2 liter V8 engine. However, considering this engine was introduced in 1992, it's respectable output for that era, and on top of that, the 5.2 Magnum balances that with good overall reliability. However, no engine is perfect, and that applies here too, as the 5.2 Magnum is prone to its share of common issues. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common Chrysler 5.2 Magnum V8 engine problems. Number one on the list, we have Plenum gasket leaks. Now, the intake manifold on the 5.2 Magnum is actually a two-piece design, and Chrysler used a steel plate in between the pieces, which includes a plenum gasket to seal everything together. This is one of the most common issues on the 5.2 Magnum, is that that gasket tends to go bad with age and mileage, and then ultimately results in a leak from the intake manifold and specifically from around that plenum gasket. So especially considering the current age and mileage of the 5.2 Magnum, and something that really plagues almost all of these engines, so by now chances are a lot of these have already been replaced. There are a lot of aftermarket solutions, repair kits, and longer term fixes for this problem. So if you do run into issues with the plenum gasket on the 5.2 Magnum, would highly recommend checking out some aftermarket options and potentially upgrading that to address it for the longer term, just since if you keep replacing it with factory parts, those will continue to go bad. A couple common symptoms to be on the lookout for when it comes to plenum gasket leaks are misfires, rough idle, poor performance, fouled spark plugs, and potentially catalytic converter and oxygen sensor issues. And that's partly because as this plenum goes bad, it can actually cause additional fuel to be injected into the engines, which can in turn wipe out things like oxygen sensors and catalytic converters. So if you're noticing issues with those components and have a couple of these symptoms, then certainly something to check out and get fixed if you do indeed have issues with that plenum gasket. Moving on to the second most common problem, we have issues with the camshaft position sensor. Now, this is a very simple, straightforward issue. The camshaft position sensor is responsible for monitoring the speed and position of the camshaft in the 5.2 Magnum. Now, as an electrical sensor, this is something that tends to go bad with age and mileage. They're prone to getting gunked up and kind of grimed up on the sensor itself, or it may fail electronically. And so there are a couple options. If you do run into issues with the camshaft position sensor, you can try simply cleaning it up and removing any dirt or debris or grime from the camshaft position sensor and reinstalling it. A lot of the times, if it's just due to that will be a short-term solution. However, the camshaft position sensor is only a roughly $25 to $50 part, so a lot of the times it makes sense to just go ahead and knock that out, get a new camshaft position sensor, and get that installed. That way you don't have to go back in there messing with things multiple times, especially if you clean it. Sometimes that may only work for 2, 3, 6 extra months, so it can buy you a little bit of extra time, but oftentimes it's worth it to just go ahead and replace that sensor altogether, since again, it's generally only about $25 to $50. Moving on to our third and final common problem, we have broken exhaust manifold bolts. The exhaust manifold bolts are a known weakness on the 5.2 Magnum, and eventually these bolts end up breaking, which can allow some separation between the exhaust manifold and the engine, which ultimately results in an exhaust leak. So nothing major a lot of the times. It's not something that tends to cause any significant symptoms or really issues with the vehicle, but a couple things to be on the lookout for here include ticking sounds. A lot of people associate this actually with lifter tick, but on the 5.2 Magnum, any ticking sounds are often these exhaust manifold bolts, because this is another one of those relatively common issues that people run into, as well as any raw exhaust gas smells, especially coming from up front near the engine bay, and a couple less common symptoms that are tough to notice, but you might notice if the leak gets bad enough, are poor fuel economy and poor performance. A lot of the times this may go unnoticed until you have to have the car inspected or do an emissions test on the vehicle, at which point an exhaust leak will result in failing that emissions test. So very important there to get this addressed if you do need to have your vehicle emissions tested soon. You're not going to pass with an exhaust manifold bolt issue and a leak from that exhaust manifold. So that's really the biggest issue there. But otherwise, again, pretty minor issue in the grand scheme. Just go ahead and replace those bolts. And also while you're in there, it is a good idea to replace the exhaust manifold gaskets just to ensure you cover all of your grounds with this issue. So really that wraps up the most common problems with the Chrysler 5.2 Magnum engine. Ultimately, this is a reliable engine and one that doesn't suffer from many serious common problems. Again, most of the things I discussed throughout this video are pretty minor in the grand scheme of things. We talked about the camshaft position sensor, which is an inexpensive part and pretty easy to replace, especially if you have a little bit of DIY experience. Then there are the intake plenum gasket issues. Now, this is an extremely common issue, but since it's such a well-known problem, again, there are tons of long-term fixes and solutions with aftermarket parts for this. So if you run into that issue, definitely something to consider just so you can knock this out for the longer term and not have to keep worrying about it every 50 or 100,000 miles. And then lastly, the exhaust manifold bolts, which are another relatively minor issue with these engines, something that's not going to cause any major drivability concerns or issues and really shouldn't affect overall reliability and longevity. However, you will have trouble passing any emissions testing with an exhaust leak from the manifold, so something to keep in mind there. One final thing to mention with the 5.2 Magnum, again, we are talking about an engine that was built from 1992 up until 2003. So at this point, we're talking about a 20 to 30 year old engine. They can still be very reliable even to this day. However, an engine that old just takes a toll on any engine, so it is going to require a little extra TLC to keep things up and running well. But with proper maintenance and repairs, the 5.2 Magnum V8 can still be a very reliable engine to this day. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.